Hey, welcome back, everybody. My name is Michael Buckman. And since I've been talking a lot about ALM and Power Platform recently, I thought it'd be fitting to cover one of the cooler features that Power Platform has come out with around this topic, and that's ALM Accelerator. So let's dive in. Okay, so I just wanted to quickly cover what ALM is. ALM stands for Application Lifecycle Management. It includes governance, development, and maintenance. In previous videos, I've covered how you can implement ALM and Power Platform solutions with Azure DevOps and GitHub. Now, I want to cover a very cool feature that Microsoft has developed called the ALM Accelerator. It's built on top of Azure DevOps, but you really don't even need to go inside of Azure DevOps, and you can stay within your Power Platform environment within this tool to manage ALM and your Power Platform solutions. It's pretty awesome. So let's go check it out. Okay, so first off, I just want to say that Microsoft has great documentation around the ALM Accelerator. So I'm not going to dive too deep in how to configure it and how to get it up and running and how to use it because Microsoft covers that really well. But I will give you a high-level overview of how it works. We can see it in my environment and we can see it in action. I brought you to this diagram because I think it paints the picture really well. We have a solution and we have three makers for that solution. Each of them are pushing changes to the main branch of this solution. So, whenever one of the makers needs to push their change, they'll go to the ALM Accelerator Canvas app, which then communicates with Azure DevOps. That maker goes to the Canvas app, commits their changes, that will push it to basically a staging branch. It will then validate the changes with the main solution to make sure there's no conflicts or no errors or nothing bad is happening when we merge that change into the main branch. So a bunch of validations happen. That happens within the validation environment. Once that gets validated, everything looks good. It then pushes it to the test environment. That's where testing can occur. And once the testing's occurred and everything looks great, we then can create a pull request for the main branch, which will then push to production. All of this is done with just a few clicks by the maker. And everything can be monitored via the ALM Accelerator Canvas app. I'm going to throw the link to the ALM Accelerator documentation in the description below. Okay, so there are two Canvas apps that come with the ALM Accelerator. One's an administration app where you can configure everything within the ALM Accelerator. And the other is the main app that everyone will use to commit solutions, deploy solutions, and lots of other things. So let's quickly go over the administration app and see what we can do inside of here. We can see all of our DevOps projects just within this app. We don't even have to go over to Azure DevOps, which is pretty awesome. We can even create new projects within Azure DevOps inside of this app. There's a project wizard that will help you configure a project just for the ALM Accelerator and configure service connections and connect environments and all that jazz, all within this app. You don't have to go anywhere inside of Azure DevOps, and you don't even have to go inside of the environments. You can use the project wizard to even create projects within Azure DevOps, and that will allow you to create service connections right off the bat to your environments in Power Platform. Now, you still do need to go to your Power Platform environment and add the application user, so don't forget to do that. But when we click on a project here, we can see all the different details of this project. We can see the team members, all the pipelines, the repositories, service connections, variable groups. Some of this stuff comes out of the box when you configure a project via the project wizard. So you'll see some out-of-the-box repositories and pipelines. It's pretty cool, all the things that it adds. Now, there's a few things up here that we need to configure before we start using ALM Accelerator. You need to have deployment user settings. You need to have a deployment profile for each solution. And you can also see all the requests that are going through your ALM Accelerator. so you can kind of keep an eye on things. Now, the deployment user settings, and we'll see this in the main app, really controls what people can see and can't see. And you can assign AD groups to each user setting. Okay, so now let's go check out the main app. So first thing I want to show you is the thing that we were just talking about, the user settings. Now I can see all of them because I'm a part of all of these groups since I'm an admin, but a user might just see one, and this is going to drive what they see on the screen. So if I change this, you'll see some things go away. And when we go to commit solution and deploy solution, there's going to be some settings that are taken away from the user. Okay, so I have an example solution, the ALM example solution. Pretty clever, I know. And Dave wants to push a change to this solution. He's made some changes in his development environment, and he wants to push them to production. So he's going to go ahead and commit solution. Now, you can enter a note regarding this change that's been made. So let's just say I updated a label. Very simple. There's a few things that you can do here. You can say, I want to check in solution and settings, just the solution, just settings, or just the power page. I'm going to do solution and settings. Now there's a show advanced option here. This can be managed for users. That can be hidden if you don't want users messing with this. But I want to show you what you can do here. So I've already checked in a change in this environment and for the solution. So a branch is already created for me. So it's saying, hey, let's check in to the same branch that we checked in before. Or you could create a new branch. I'm not going to do that. We're going to keep this. I'm going to keep all the settings the same, include power pages, even though I don't have power pages. We're going to make sure that all my customizations are published, and we're going to bypass the prepare just to speed things up here. So I'm going to commit solution. Okay, you can see that things are pending here and things are grayed out. Now, what's really cool is we get linked directly to Azure DevOps. Now, you don't have to go into Azure DevOps, but it's pretty cool that we can see what's actually happening within Azure DevOps, and we can follow the logs. You can also go to this nice little view within the ALM Accelerator to kind of see a history of what has happened and what's pending. So we can see that I have a commit solution action that is currently pending. Now, if I go back here, this will take some time to run. So I'm going to pause the video here and wait for this to finish. Okay, so one thing that I want to show you is you can configure deployment settings within the ALM Accelerator. And there's some really useful stuff inside here. One of the main things I want to show you is the environment variables, because I think this is super cool. We have a dropdown of all of our different environments. So validation, our test environment, and prod. And again, validation is where everything gets combined and a bunch of tests are run to make sure that the solution looks good and operates correctly. Once that's done, it's pushed to test, where testing will occur and users will validate. And then after that, we can push to production. So we can go through each of our environments. We can see we have I have an environment variable, and it's just a string, and it's really just to show that these are getting set in each environment. So I've named this validation for this environment variable, and in test, I've named it test, and then in prod, I've named it prod. So all of these different settings are environment specific, and you can set them right here within the ALM Accelerator. Again, a super cool feature. Okay, so our solution was committed successfully, and we got a nice green check mark. And we can go back here and we can see that I have a successful commit. Now, our solution has been committed into our branch. Now we want to deploy this. So let's deploy it. Super easy. You can see that my last deployment was successful with a green check mark there. Again, you can go and see the history of that. I'm going to go ahead and deploy this though. We're going to say we made a small change. No worries here. Okay, so now that my commit was successful, I can go ahead and deploy this and start the deployment process. What this is going to do is run some tests and validation. Then it's going to push to test. Okay, so let's deploy this change. We're going to say just a small change. I am just making a small change to production. Okay, and we can see that our source branch is the branch that I committed to, my personal branch. And the target branch is the ALM example. So it created this branch as kind of the mix for all of the different developer branches. So this is my developer branch, and we're going to push it to ALM example branch where everything will get validated. I'm going to bypass approval, but you can require approval for these things as well. Let's go ahead and deploy solution. And I'm going to pause as this will take a second. Okay, so the deployment is finished. We can see the green check. I want to show you what exactly happened in DevOps though, because this is pretty cool. Okay, we can see my deployment here, just a small change, gave it a title. It runs a bunch of validations. It checks for any merge conflicts. But let's look at what these build validations are doing. Let's check this pipeline. Okay, look at all the actions that Microsoft has built in to check and make sure that this solution is valid and that there is nothing bad happening when we are merging our change into the main branch. Pretty awesome. We're getting all of this for free, all of these actions that they've built in. Some pretty cool stuff in here, and I think it's super valuable what they have given us to be able to validate these updates from different developers into one main branch. Okay, so now where are we in this process? We have committed our change, and then we have pushed to the validation and test environment. So it validated and then pushed it to test. So now we would then theoretically go and test our solution in the test environment. But I'm going to show you just quickly what we would do to push this to production. So I'm going to go and commit solution. And I'm going to commit to the main branch. First, I need to give this a title. Okay, so now what do? We want to push this to production. First thing we need to do is, again, commit the solution. And we're basically going to create a pull request into the main branch. So I'm going to select main and give this a note, pushing this small change to prod. We're going to commit solution. Okay, so this is committing this change into main, and which will kick off the build for production. Now this is going to take a minute. So let's just wrap this up here. Let's look at everything that we can do within the ALM accelerator. We started in our development environment. We had a change that we wanted to push first to validation and then to test. And then that all got validated by deploying that solution or that change in validation and test. Once everything was validated there and there were no errors, we now feel comfortable to create a pull request for the main branch, which will then kick off a, which then we can kick off a deployment to production. So some pretty cool stuff here. I definitely encourage you to play around in the ALM Accelerator and go through the Microsoft documentation, because it does a really good job of walking you through all the different features of the ALM Accelerator. That concludes our ALM Accelerator demo and walkthrough. I hope you enjoyed it. I really love talking about this topic because I think it's a super powerful tool that Microsoft has provided us for free with a ton of built-in functionality that would take forever to build. That's all I've got, folks. Until next time.